Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Listen. I'm Pumpkin.
And I'm Yessy.
And this month we are starting things off with celebrating the birthday of one of our favorite artists of all time.
Who is it?
Miss Britney Spears.
Yes, it's Britney, betch.
Betch. While listening to our iconic album, In the Zone.
Yes, we love it. Okay. This is a story about a girl named Britney. Britney was born on December 2nd, 1981 in Macomb, Mississippi and raised in Kentwood, Louisiana. As a child, she took dance and voice lessons and also took gymnastic classes.
Oh.
You know, she always did flips and stuff and yes. She's so flexible.
Yes.
She entered in talent shows, appeared in stage productions and television series, including the Mickey Mouse Club, before signing with Jive Records in 1997.
She's jiving.
Okay, she's jiving. Since her music debut, Britney has made a name for herself as the queen of pop. We said it.
Don't at us.
Okay, don't. Sorry. She's a queen of pop. Fight me. And she changed pop music and pop culture as we know it. You know it's true. Godney is responsible for some of the greatest pop albums of all time, including her debut, Baby One More Time.
Duh.
Oops, I Did It Again.
Duh.
Blackout.
Duh.
Duh. And In the Zone.
Of course.
Yes.
In the Zone is her fourth studio album, which was released on November the 12th, 2003. 16 years ago. 16. 16! So long.
That is. My youth is gone.
Musically, In the Zone ranges from dance to house, reggae, trip-hop, and hip-hop styles, with instrumentations ranging from guitars to drums, synthesizers to strings, and even some Middle Eastern instrumentations.
Yes. Oh, it's just such a great album. She began writing songs for In the Zone, despite not knowing the direction of the album. The first song recorded was The Touch of My Hand, which Britney claims set the mood for the entire album. She co-wrote every song except four tracks, people. Proof that she is so talented. And also changed the lyrics to suit herself. The album has a very sexual vibe, which Britney has explained in the past that the risque themes were subconscious and happened while she was developing the album. And get in the zone, I feel you, Brit.
In the Zone became a huge success, debuting at the top of the charts all across the world. In the U.S., she became the second female artist in Billboard's to have four consecutive albums at number one. Janet Jackson held the most at the time with five.
Oh, iconic.
Iconic.
Yes.
In the Zone was certified double platinum and also received positive reviews from music critics who complimented its mix of different styles and Britney's songwriting.
Yes.
In the Zone marked the end of her teen pop star persona and the beginning of her being recognized as a legitimate female artist.
She's legit, y'all. She's legit. And I'm so glad that she got positive reviews because it's just a great album.
It is.
It solidified the legendary Miss Britney Spears as the pop icon that we all know and love, while showcasing her music creativity and songwriting skills.
Mm-hmm.
We are super happy to celebrate the birth of our goddess. So, without further ado, let's kick things off with the first track, Me Against the Music, featuring
Madonna.
Okay, here we go.
Grab a partner, take it down.
Take it down, and Madonna. It's just me and me.
And okay. Me.
Oh my god, like this whole video is just so good.
The
like,
dancing.
The dancing, the IKEA bed making process, and Madonna just doing all her yoga everywhere.
Her Kabbalah yoga stuff.
Her Kabbalah yoga everywhere, and it's just, it's just such a nice dancey song, and so good.
Such fast, intricate footwork.
Oh, I love it. I used to know the dance moves to this. I think it's kind of like fading away.
Oh, no, you have to practice.
I can't.
Practice makes perfect.
I can't. I'm old. But if Madonna can do it, then I guess I can too, right?
Yeah. She's old.
Yeah. But, you know, she's all right. Well, this era, she was wonderful. I don't know.
So I was actually reading some things online. Thank you, online and Wikipedia. But apparently, Madonna first heard this song while Britney and Madonna were practicing for their iconic 2003 MTV Video Music Awards. And Madonna just commented on, you know, how much she liked the track. And Britney was all like, hey, y'all wanna just, you know, come and join me for the song?
Okay.
And she said, yeah. So it wasn't intended to be a duet, but they made it happen. And thank you, Madonna, for...
Oh my God. That legendary performance at the VMAs. I was watching it yesterday and I was just like, that had everything I ever wanted in my life. And it's just like bittersweet because it's just so great, but then it's like, I don't think that will ever happen again. It had Britney, it had Christina, it had Justin Timberlake freaking the fuck out because he saw his ex kissing another woman.
It had Diddy looking all weird.
Yeah, it had Diddy looking weird. It had, like, oh my God, everybody in the audience was just, Snoop Dogg was
He's laughing.
He couldn't stop laughing. And then it has the iconic, legendary Missy Elliott. With a freaking Adidas tux.
That was amazing.
Adidas suit tux. Like, come on. Oh, so good.
So good.
It probably will never happen again, y'all. No. So, be blessed if you actually saw it at that time. But also be blessed that you can still see it now.
YouTube, thank you.
YouTube, thank you, indeed. So, the next song is I Got That Boom Boom.
Featuring boom, boom.
The Yin Yang Twins. So, let's hear it.
This was never my favorite song, admittedly.
Yeah.
But
I'm into it right now.
It's a good like party style song. Got some Atlanta vibes.
It's got some for the Southern boys out there too.
Southern boys out there.
She's fine enough to blow your mind. Ooh. Let me blow your mind.
Evie.
And Gwen.
That's
a great song.
I miss Steve.
I miss her too. Oh, and Gwen.
Well,
she was better.
She was good.
Now, yeah. that time Gwen, because she was a lot better.
I mean, I liked The Sweet Escape. That was a good album.
Yeah, very good. Here
it is. Oh. But you don't like country.
Because nothing like screams hip hop than, you know, banjo. Only Britney can mix those two things together.
Right.
That's the icon that she is. Okay? Yes.
wrong era, but whatever.
Hey, it's her dance move. It can basically be done in any song.
It can be. Did she do this for TRL? What was it? For the TRL or was it the ABC one? Or did she do both?
She did both. She for sure did the ABC. I think she did this for TRL as well. She did Me Against the Music. And she did this song. And she had her cute little fedora hat. I think she did for both.
She was really trying to make this a single.
She really was, actually.
It wasn't.
About this song is like, I just feel like with the facts of her writing these, obviously this was not one that she wrote.
No.
So it's like, I can kind of like hear it.
Yeah.
You know, I can kind of tell, especially with the other songs that we're gonna hear. You can, you know, when she says like it had like the theme of the like sexiness and stuff. Yeah, this song, you know.
Hang out that boom,
yeah,
boom.
There's some like, you know, sexual innuendos and all that, but I don't know. Like beat wise and stuff. It's definitely a song of the now if it's back then.
Mm-hmm.
You know. But it's still a good song. I'm not saying that I like, oh, I don't like it, but
it's not skippable.
Yeah.
But I also would rather listen to the next song, yes. Showdown.
Yes, Showdown is amazing.
Amazing.
Let's go. Yes. Now this song is like super sexual.
That also like, reminds me of like...
Yes. The Femme Fatale cap.
The Femme Fatale cap. It also reminds me though, wait, is this like a showdown when like Justin... Was this like a Justin versus Britney showdown dance-off? I think it was. Here comes the showdown.
I got
what comes
one.
Around goes around.
I got another one. What goes around comes around. Yeah, and then he says that in one of his songs, but like much, much later. Remember?
I do.
Like, maybe it could be. Because obviously we all know that this album was after she broke up with Justin. So there's some themes to it as well in this album.
If y'all haven't seen the Lifetime biography,
yeah,
it's good. But there was one scene in that lovely movie that had Britney and Justin having a little dance off in some club.
So good.
It's so good, but so terrible.
Yeah, that movie. The casting was not...
questionable.
Yeah, that was not taken seriously. And maybe they just did that on purpose. Like, are we supposed to, like, take any, like, biography of a Lifetime seriously?
A Lifetime? No. But What's Love Got to Do with It? That was a good one.
Is that Lifetime?
No, it's just a regular movie. It's a real, real movie.
Okay. See, that's legit. Lifetime is not.
Sorry, Lifetime.
Sorry, Lifetime.
It's our opinions.
Yeah, it is. Don't fight us. But seriously, we're right. We're right on. So here's a little fact. Unfortunately, back in 2003, when this first came out, I wasn't like not like hating on Britney. But I just kind of stopped listening to her. You know, I've been a fan of her since she first started and everything. But then 2003, I was in high school and I was just like listening to other music, rock alternative and indie. And for some weird reason, my stupid little mind was just like, oh, I only have to listen to like rock or pop. And I can't listen to both. And it was just kind of, ugh. But anyways, so unfortunately, I didn't really get to like enjoy this album when it first came out because I just wasn't listening to it at the time.
I get it. I mean, I was also listening to other stuff too, but I couldn't stay away from songs like Toxic or
I remember
Against the Music because the first video, the lead single, and like I was just like so shocked that Madonna was on her album that I had to go back to pop for a minute, but
yeah,
I get it though.
I was rebelling, listening to Avril Lavigne, because that's not pop.
It's complicated.
Avril Lavigne. Now I was listening to other indie stuff, but anyways, so I actually listened to this album in its entirety like years later, and I just love it and appreciate it. You know, so I don't know, maybe like my teenage Yessy would have appreciated, like, I don't know, but like even with her other albums too, like Oops, I Did It Again and all that, you know, like things I listened to when I was younger.
Yeah.
You know, as an adult, you understand it more, like you understand the meanings more and you're like, oh, she really is not that innocent.
Next.
Listening to the next song.
Breathe on Me.
Breathe. No, I don't want people to breathe on me.
Please don't breathe on me.
Please don't breathe on me.
Especially on the bus.
Ew. They're just like right next to you.
Just like in the I'm a Slave for You video. They're all like...
Oh, yeah. I don't understand why she would let people do that. And then there's just, like this one guy that just like literally like shoves his tongue on the side of her cheek. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
I'm just like, did she know that was going to happen? I just like appreciate that she was doing it in her Vegas residencies. She did it for like a music award performance, like medley. I think it was either Billboard or American Music.
Yeah,
one of those.
Where she like did like a mega mix of all her songs. She was receiving some kind of like legendary or like some crazy award and
for being legendary.
She should just
get all the awards.
I was like shocked that she did mostly in the zone, to be honest, and she did not singles for that performance, and that was ironical.
Yeah. Like, obviously she's a toxic, because duh.
Duh, I'm here.
But, like, I just really like that she's been doing Breathe On Me and Touch My Hand a lot.
Me too.
So,
it should have been singles, but, I mean, you can only have so many singles, I guess.
You can only have so many, but, I really like this song as I am older and got to listen to it more, and, you know, it's just sexy and just,
it's like the beat is good.
The beat is great, and her voice is just, oh, yeah, baby.
Fun fact.
Ooh.
Fun fact. Brittany actually recorded this song the same day as And Then We Kissed.
I love that song!
But unfortunately, I don't know why, but And Then We Kissed kind of...
And then we kissed, and then they were gone.
They were gone. It just wasn't released. It was put to the back burner.
Yeah.
However...
Yes.
Fortunately...
Yes.
It was featured in Be In The Mix compilation remix album. It was the Junkie XL, version. So we did get it eventually. But if you look somewhere in the YouTube, you'll find the original mix of it. And I like the original mix.
I love it. I feel like it would fit perfectly with this album.
It really would.
The remix or the original, you know? I got that Boom Boom could have been like a B-side or something. But, at least we were blessed to be able to listen to And Then We Kissed. Because that's honestly one of my favorite songs
of all time.
Yes, of all time. It's so beautiful. Like, it's just, I can listen to that song on repeat.
On repeat?
Like, all the time. But then I can listen to so many of her songs on repeat. A lot!
Especially Early Morning.
Early Morning. Yeah. I love that. It's my favorite.
Morning.
Oh, I love that. She sounds
hungover.
She sounds so hungover. She sounds tired. She needs a break.
I feel like this song is almost like... It's like this. No, I feel like this is... like the prequel to Blur on Circus.
Oh, yeah.
Because, like, it was like she's talking about, like, this is like her partying all night in New York, like, trying to find names of the clubs. Yeah. Like, the song has some percolating beats. Like, I don't know, she's like purring and talking and she's like
whispering.
She's whispering. But, like, Blur is, like, the next day, like, she's like, what happened? Like, that was all a blur. Like, I did too many
after
drugs.
After the early morning.
It's all a blur.
It's kind of like a walk of shame kind of, like, anthem. Wish we can all relate to what? I don't know why that should be something we should be. Don't be thankful for that, sorry. Just a good, like, feel-good jam to dance to. Early morning. This could be my alarm clock. Early morning.
I think Toxic is most people's alarm clock, which is the next song on the album.
Toxic. Like, I feel like this is Britney's... Like, if you tell people, like, oh, I love Britney Spears, and for some, sorry, stupid reason, they're like, who's Britney? Then you're just like, excuse me, Toxic, and you play it, or you sing it, or like, whatever. Oh. And they'd be like, oh, that! And you're just like, ugh. I don't need to talk to you anymore.
We're
I
done.
Just needed to educate you. So you can know who Britney is, but bye.
Bye.
Bye. Like, I don't want you in my life. If you don't know Britney, like, I don't need you. I really don't.
Get gone.
Get gone. Sorry. Sorry, not sorry.
This video, iconic. She's definitely feeling her Jennifer Garner alias oats with the red hair and being like a spy on a mission to kill men.
And then, it's my favorite. And then the flight attendant.
Yeah,
and then the brunette putting the poison. Which one's your favorite, Britney?
Probably the brunette. climbing up the, yes, the side of the building with those suction cups. But I also like her red hair look when she's doing the cartwheels up, like, to try to avoid all those lasers.
Oh,
or,
yes, you know, that's iconic. Yeah. Of course it is.
Very Resident Evil, like, alias realness.
Yes, it's just, this song is just, yeah, again, it's iconic, it's legendary, everybody, anybody knows the song.
And apparently it was written, and co-written and produced by Mike Snow, I just found out recently when I was reading about Mike Snow, and I was all like, wait, what? Shooketh.
And I love what you do, but you know that.
Also, I didn't realize this either, but this song was originally offered to Kylie Minogue.
I have another one!
Oh!
I have another one!
Oh, good, it's your last one.
It's my last one, so the last shocking news better be good. This is, though, very shocking. Kylie Minogue, she's queen. We love her, but...
I could see her doing it, but it's...
Can you?
I could. I could see her doing it.
Her own little spin on it? I think
it would be more like electro and less pop, probably, but...
Do you think you would still have the little...
Who could ever say?
Yeah, right? And isn't this her only, like, Grammy-winning song?
Yeah, Mike Snow and Britney got a Grammy for this one.
Yeah, I mean, she's way more deserving of more, but again...
She's been nominated before, but...
She's been nominated, but...
Oh, well.
You know, she doesn't need those awards to prove her worth.
Her only winning one Grammy is outrageous.
It's outrageous.
This is like the song that never was. I mean, it was a song, and it is a song, and it was the fourth single
it's
and final single.
It's the video that never was.
It's the video that never was.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
So, yeah, it's a really good song, and it's just, it kind of also sounds like one of Beyonce's songs.
It could have been Beyonce.
Naughty Girl?
Oh, yeah.
Right? It has that little, the background beat and those little flutes and stuff, so...
And this song is basically just talking about how extravagant her life is, like materialism, like having fun,
yes,
like her sex drive, going on a shopping spree, going on a world tour. It's like her life.
This is her life. And
it's outrageous.
And it's outrageous. And it would have been all fine and dandy if she didn't get freaking hurt during the video. And it basically kind of like ruined her like dancing abilities. Not that she can't dance per se, but you know, for those of you know those real fans out there have noticed the changes. I don't know, as like, you know, always just worshiping her dance moves and everything about her dancing, and
her,
again,
her performing.
As a child, we talked about it, she was pretty much dancing since she was a baby and took dancing lessons and stuff, so that must have been real hard for her with that accident happening.
Yeah, well, she hurt her knee. Well, she's hurt herself many times, like on the Stronger video shoot, and Oops, I Did It Again video shoot, and hit her head.
It hit her freaking head.
Sometimes she got an injury,
too. Oh, yeah,
too.
She got one of her ankles. Yeah.
But I feel like the Outrageous video shoot was like the most injured she's been to date, at least as far as I know.
Yeah.
And it ultimately canceled her Onyx tour. In the U.S. at least.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's sad.
It is sad.
Touch of my hand.
Yes.
The touch of my hand.
My hand.
My hand.
My hand.
My hand!
It's mine. I do love the violins.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
The string arrangements. It's just almost like kind of dreamlike.
Yeah,
know?
Well, I mean, when you're...
I mean, masturbating, yeah.
You can be in a euphoric kind of state of mind.
Yeah, so it fits perfect. It's just the perfect, like, perfect music.
Tell
she's
us.
Not
she's not ashamed.
Okay.
It's obscene, Britney.
I know. It's like she's kind of like... telling us, like,
she's being really vulnerable right now.
She's being vulnerable, but she's kind of like a little cautious or a little scared. Like, oh, how is this gonna feel?
Britney has said that she felt that this song is comparable to That's the Way Love Goes by Janet Jackson. Mm. Again, another Jackson ref.
Yes.
And I feel like they do have a similar, like, register of, like, vocals. Like, they have similar, like, lower registers on this track that I really enjoy.
Again, I'm also just happy that she is, like, was reviving this song again and putting it in her... in her set list.
Yeah, it's another one that she's been playing live a lot, which is pretty cool. But I mean, what's great is that touch of my hand, after you get all that out, then you can go on and get your hookup on and have time of your life.
Yeah.
Which is the next song,
The Hookup. I love that. You like followed that up so nicely.
I'm trying to have these segues, you know what I'm saying?
This is like soda pop, like part two.
It's not our favorite.
It's not, but it's like definitely a song of back then. Definitely. I feel like that was so 2003.
What if like Sean Paul was on this track?
It could have worked with Boom Boom and this one. They were just like add-ons, like I don't know if they fit well with the theme, but...
It was music of the time. So
Music of the time, yeah. So I feel like those were fillers, even though And Then We Kiss could have totally been in this album. And then doesn't she also have a B-side, The Answer?
Oh, The Answer.
The Answer totally could have been... I don't know.
That's a good one.
Yeah, right? Mm. So it's just like... I wonder how much of choices... did Britney have in selecting the singles? Was it just all her management, or did she have a say in it?
I feel like she was living in their shadow. The next song.
This is so good for my life. I love it. But it is true, though. I feel like she was just...
living in their shadow.
But then this song, I also kind of feel, has like some like Justin Timberlake-y, like...
Yeah.
Like Lifetime movie, you know. But this is actually one of my favorite songs.
It's a great like mid-tempo. I mean, we would call it a 100% ballad, but
yeah,
it's definitely a mid-tempo song.
Yeah,
she's talking about like reminders of a lover that still lingers on after like they're gone.
Linger.
No. Nope.
I wonder if she's talking about Timberlake.
I mean, probably.
Yeah. I mean, we don't... There's, you know, his story, her story.
It's really all her story.
Yeah, so. It's really all her story that matters. But, I don't know. Yeah, Justin, he was really in love with her.
I'm glad that they broke up, to be honest. I'm sorry. I know that's not like a popular opinion, but I think Britney, although this hasn't necessarily done better post Justin, can. You know why? She's a brave new girl.
Oh my god, don't you dare! Like, I'm not even like, you are like so ahead of me. I think there's people ahead of me.
There's people ahead of us.
Okay. Do you guys think the time travel speed is real?
I think there's people ahead of us.
Okay. When did that movie Spunk come out?
That's like a new movie and stuff.
Okay, I love it.
What? Where have I been?
Where have I been? Oh, so good. That's iconic.
It's chaotic.
It is chaotic. That's a good song, actually. Oh. That's a really good song. Ah! Britney! How old are you?
You're a brave new girl.
I am a brave new girl, which is...
the next track. Brave New Girl, what a good song. Talking about young ladies finding their passions and losing their inhibitions. And oh, it's fun. It's kind of funky, electro-y. Yeah.
I kind of feel like it's a, like, she kind of purposely followed it up with Shadow. It's like, she went through this like sad like kind of breakup, yep. but now she's like a brave new girl. So watch out, Justin Timberlake.
Right?
She's gonna go and kiss Madonna in front of you.
And you're not gonna like it.
You are not.
Every time I think about Christina Aguilera, I think about Britney's. Every time.
Love it.
Which is just the next song.
Which is the next song, if y'all didn't know. Oh my god. That is iconic. Aww. Every time is so sad.
Last track.
I definitely feel like it is a response to Justin Timberlake's Cry Me a River. Also, like, her, I guess, her story of, like, her version of, like, how she felt about the breakup. I don't know if she's ever, like, confirmed that, but, I mean, come on.
She's just, like, when asked, she's, like, let the song speak for itself.
Yeah.
Basically saying, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Of course it is, but I'm not gonna openly say it. I thought that her ABC performance and little special was really amazing, especially when they were showing this song, because she actually told us, like, so she wrote the little piano riff.
Yeah, even the video, like, it's just so heartbreaking.
The original concept for that video?
Yes.
I kind of wish that would have happened.
Explain. What was the original?
It was supposed to be, like, she was supposed to, like, be so sad and distraught that she was supposed to, like, kill herself. And they asked either her label or her management or somebody thought that it was too macabre, too dark. So they changed it up a little bit. Rather than her dying, like, have her being reincarnated, but then at the very end, she's fine. She's not dead.
I guess she was dreaming. It was all a dream.
A dream within a dream tour.
Yes.
Oh. I saw that tour. It was good.
You're so lucky.
I'm a star.
Yeah, but you cry.
With my lonely heart.
Oh, thinking. If there's nothing missing in my life,
then why
do these tears come at night?
Not in the daytime, only at night.
I'm all seeing what she's been through. She's basically, you know, she's a Miss American Dream since she was 17. And, like, hello. Like, she's just she's
all the
just
way to the Philippines.
Favorites. Yeah, they're going to put her pictures of her derriere in the magazines. So, she's a goddess. I love this album, especially listening to it more as an adult. And that's when I first started listening to it. But as I was more and more, kept hearing it, I'm just it's a really good, like,
it wants you to give you more.
Yeah. Which more. Is not our next
no,
one.
No, it's not. So what kind of pumpkins are you going to give it?
Obviously a 5.
Duh. I mean, hello, 5.
Hello, we're not celebrating Britney's birthday and giving her anything less.
I mean, we could do a 10.
Yeah, it's a 10 from the both of us.
Uh-huh.
Can sing, she can dance, and she can write.
She
can do it all. Okay?
And she's an actor, too.
Yes. She is. She's an actress. Crossroads.
Sabrina.
Will
and Grace.
Oh my god.
SNL.
She's an SNL. She's an Austin Powers.
Oh, Austin Powers.
Yes.
Fembot.
She is a fembot.
Pepsi commercials.
Oh,
Pepsi.
For those who think young, wink. I love that. Oh, so good. But anyways, she is iconic, legendary, and we hope she has an amazing birthday month, birthday
Happy
week,
birthday, Britney.
Birthday year. Can this, like, year just be hers and just, like, I want her to be free and...
Free Britney. Hashtag free Britney.
And live her life without all these people just controlling her. That needs to stop immediately. But until then, let's just hope that she's just okay, and whenever she feels ready, we are beyond ready for new music.
Beyond.
But until then, we'll just listen to the classics.
We'll be patiently waiting.
Patiently waiting. Yeah, patiently.
But tell us what y'all think. What are your feelings when you first heard this record? Where are some of the standout tracks?
Mm-hmm.
Let us know in the comments below. I think that's going to do it for this episode, though.
Yeah, because we can talk about Britney for, like, hours and hours and hours, and I, like, we just won't stop. But we have to.
At some point, we do.
Yeah. Sorry.
That's all.
That's all.
But yeah, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit those notification bells, follow on the Instagrams, and we'll see you next time.
Yeah.
Bye.
Yeah.
Yeah.